In this tutorial, you'll learn to render a 360-degree panorama of your 3D scene that you can view on your phone or with the help of a Google Cardboard. Interestingly, the tool that enables you that output has been around in 3ds Max for a while, so if you haven't used it yet, now's your chance. The fact that you can view this type of output on a mobile device makes the tool even trendier nowadays. Open the scene named denpano.max you downloaded for this tutorial. A download link is available in the description section of this movie. The scene shows a den, or family room, complete with furniture and props. It is also set up with lights and various cameras. The scene uses physical materials to complement the Autodesk Ray Tracer engine chosen for final renders. You can test render the scene if you wish. Ultimately, you need a more central camera position for a 360 rendering. Zoom in on the center of the room in the top view. Create a physical camera in the center of the room, pointing to the terrace. Set the new camera view into a viewport, and pan the view to move the camera up to eye level. In the Modify panel, set the EV value to about 9 or 10 to accommodate this scene. You can do a test render if you want. The way panorama renderings work in 3ds Max is that you need to create 6 square renders representing various directions. These would be front, back, left, right, up, down. From that point, the square images need to be stitched together into spherical panorama. Doing this manually would be fairly tedious. For starters, you would need 6 cameras, or a single animated camera, with an FOV value of 90. Then, after you rendered each shot, you would need a third-party application to convert the 6 images into a seamless equilateral panorama. Fortunately, all this can be done in a much easier way using 3ds Max's Panorama Exporter. Before we get to the Panorama Exporter tool, there's an important point to mention. If you are using standard cameras, free or targeted, then you are good to go, as Panorama Exporter takes care of readjusting their FOV values. If you are using the newer physical camera, then you need to do that manually. It's really not that big a concession. All you need to do is to set the physical camera's FOV value to 90 in the Modify panel. The camera shot changes in the viewport, and ultimately at render time. As for the Panorama tool itself, it can be found in the Utilities panel under More. It has 2 options, one to create a panorama, another to view it. To create a panorama, click the Render button. The Render Setup dialog appears. Note that the output size is restricted to an aspect ratio of 2 to 1, which is what a spherical image looks like when flattened. Typically, to get a reasonable quality from a 360-degree panorama, you need at least a 6K by 3K resolution. For now, though, set it to a lower and faster to render 1024 by 512, just to understand the process. You'd need to specify an output file, name it mypano.jpg. Note also that the bottom of the dialog shows typical rendering engine adjustments, in this case as they relate to the new art renderer. When you click Render, 3ds Max starts rendering square images of the scene, 6 of them to be exact. When the 6 renders are done, the Panorama Exporter takes care of blending them into one seamless spherical map. It also displays that map in what it calls the Panorama Viewer, which you can also access from the Utilities panel. From there on, you can click and drag inside the viewer to look around the scene. You can see from the display that a resolution of 1024 by 512 is hardly adequate, so you may want to change that to a higher value. Remember that the higher the resolution, the longer the rendering time. If you set the resolution to 6000 by 3000 and crank up the quality of the renderer somewhat, be ready to wait quite a few hours for the results. A similar file has already been provided to you if you prefer to skip the wait. You can view the provided file named pano-den.jpg in the viewer and notice the difference in quality compared to a moment ago. Of course, and as mentioned earlier, the real fun begins when you put the panorama on your mobile phone. From that point on, you simply need the right app to view the panorama. In my case, I'm an Android user, so my research was restricted to that OS, although I'm sure Apple has similar tools. My research has led me to a few facts, including two distinct directions in which to view panoramas on a mobile device. One direction, the easier one, is to view the panorama in a similar way to 3ds Max's viewer by using finger swipes to look around. This can be done with practically any phone on the market today, and there are many viewer apps to that effect. The one I found useful, non-intrusive and easy to use, is called 360 Panorama Viewer by Maestro LJP. However, with most panorama viewers, as with this one, the JPEG panorama must be tagged with XMP data to be viewed properly. This led me to a different app named Photosphere Xmp Tagger that does this by duplicating your panorama and adding the necessary data to it. From that point on, you can view your panorama on pretty much any Android device. The second direction is even more fun, as it gives you a better VR experience. It lets you immerse yourself in your design with the help of a Google Cardboard. As the name implies, it is a piece of folded cardboard with two lenses inside, and it typically costs less than $10 on the internet. However, be advised that in order for this to work, your phone has to be equipped with a gyroscope in order to tilt and move your head around. Most inexpensive Android devices do not have built-in gyroscopes, so if you paid $200 or less for your phone, chances are you're out of luck. You may get lucky with some inexpensive older phones, such as the Motorola Moto G 2nd generation. It does have a built-in gyroscope, although it's a bit jittery for my taste. Still, it was a very inexpensive solution for startup VR. On the other hand, if you have one of the newer top-of-the-line phones, then you should be all set to go. If your phone does have an embedded gyroscope, then all you need is the right app to view your design with the Google Cardboard. The one I personally like best is one named PS Viewer for Google Cardboard by Education Systems. It's pretty straightforward and does the job nicely. It even has support for stereoscopic panoramas rendered with special camera rigs. As you can see, whichever method you choose, it's pretty easy to render a 360-degree panorama. The end result can be seen on PC, or better yet, on a mobile device, which is handy if you send your designs to friends, colleagues, or clients.